Today we've been asked to give an update from last year's youth symposium and where we've reached with our goals and determination in past 1 year. Well, technically speaking, I've grown 1 year older. Yeah, but thinking about it in hearts and minds, I think I've grown much more younger, inspired by you all, much more determined and focused than ever before. The more I learned about the field I am in, the younger I felt. My youth spirit encouraged me to strive even more harder in achieving the goals I've set for myself and the initiative. One thing I understood in past 1 year that we as youth can definitely change the world we are living in for better. More the networks we grow, more united we become. More determined we are towards bringing the change and seeing the change we want to see in the society. To give a brief about the initiative I started working on a year and a half back, it's called LifeCradle. It's focused on sustainable development goal number 3. 3.2 in specifics, which talks about neonatal care. According to Millennium Development Goal 4, 3 million children die just in the first week of their life, with 99% of these deaths happening in middle and lower income countries. MGD4 also mentions that most of these deaths can be saved by just providing low-tech, low-care solutions. So after an intense research, field research in India and finding two major problems related to huge equipment costs and inconsistency in electricity that affects the neonatal healthcare infrastructure in India for premature and underweight infants, we developed a low-cost baby incubator called LifeCradle that provides most basic functionality for child survival in first few critical days of its life, like warmth, clean environment, and monitoring. During our research, we met each and every stakeholder in the whole public healthcare system investigating about what happens to the newborn that needs intensive care. Well, there's no neonatal care at rural public healthcare infrastructure in India, such as sub-centers, primary health centers, and community health centers. So the child has to be referred to a district or a city-level maternity wards. When visited these sites, it was quite saddening to see the mother and child sitting on the floor waiting for their turns for the doctor to see them because there were not enough beds available. Design of LifeCradle was inspired by Finnish baby boxes, where the base of the LifeCradle is made of cardboard which goes with the child to the house for post-neonatal care. This is like an additional value to the family because most of the people don't have proper living conditions as well. When spoken to the users about how they would use these cardboard bases given them after incubation period, we got amazing responses on how helpful it can be for the child for by just acting as a makeshift cot for next 6 to 8 months. Another incident was when the child was declared dead when arrived to the hospital in an ambulance just because of some simple human error amidst all the chaos. Honestly speaking, these people are not doctors. They are just given basic training to handle these situations. But I would not blame it on human error. Instead, I would put it on the products and equipments we design. I'm sure Adam also faced some problems. So like as designers and engineers, when we develop new products, it's important that we also keep overall system level implications in our mind, making sure that each and every aspect of the user journey is taken care of. If the user and their needs are kept in the center of focus during product development process, the impact can be maximized beyond its primary functionality of the product and eventually can create a greater influence beyond its life cycle as well and on a community on a larger scale. As social enterprise, we have successfully cut down the price point of LifeCradle by 90% compared to the existing incubators in market. We have lowered these costs by innovative manufacturing techniques and reducing transportation cost by flat packing the kit and using existing infrastructure to do that. Funding definitely is one of the most important aspects in running different initiatives, and I'm sure everyone agrees over here. Initially, we did struggle getting funding, as investor scenario today looks at fast returns on investment and higher profit margins. And when you're running a social enterprise trying to cut down the costs of an existing product for affordability and social good, then the case is a little bit different, because there are really only two options you're left with. Either you compromise on the price point of your product by raising the selling prices and increasing profit margin, or to stick to your initiative's fundamental core motives of achieving the specific goals, relooking at the business models and looking at different alternative sources. So to tackle this, we started looking into different grants provided by different organizations and community social responsibility departments of big multinationals. Though initially it's a little difficult, but in the end it does matter how you do not compromise your organizational values to keep them focused in achieving these goals. We have successfully collaborated with Imperial College and St. Mary's Hospital in London, Harris Freeman Foundation in US, and Aishwarya Foundation in India. Our electronics have been developed since, and designs are getting finalized. We would be testing 200 different prototypes in 4 different districts across India by mid next year. For this, we also have started approaching different state level governments officials to bring in policy level intervention to implement such initiative, and it's important to do that at an initial stage, because later on they would just be like, oh, you've come up with just a new product, how are we going to implement that? India has highest number of preterm births in the whole world, and hence our aim in next 4 years is to get in line, and what we want is to extend full neonatal care support, extending to maternity care, which is SDG goal 3.1, at grassroots level through awareness and low-cost solutions. And our first initiative towards spreading this awareness will be launched in beginning of 2018 in different districts in north of India. Through LifeCradle, we aim to reduce infant mortality rate. I believe innovation is not only about making profits, but it's also about how we can develop cost-effective solutions to address critical problems in our society in align with United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, which most of us are trying to do here and achieve. As today's youth, we are capable of multitasking, so why should we stop at a single initiative? I believe that if it's in our power to bring that change, it becomes our responsibility as youth to do so. Along with LifeCradle, in past 1 year, we've also started working on another initiative called Crioto, a smart prosthetic socket for amputees to provide a better comfort using their smartphones. This initiative tries to solve the problem of an uncomfortable prosthetic fit, which most of the amputees have in their day-to-day lives. Our design education was focused on a user-centric approach for problem solving and innovation. With users right at the center of our research, it was all about developing products and services that would create an impact on the life of a single individual, along with accounting for social, environmental, and economical impact on a macro level. There are so many different healthcare-related problems faced today by different developing nations, and we as youth need to take action to make them better right now. Today, as a younger generation, we can use and adapt to latest technologies to solve common problems in person's day-to-day life. We can easily identify these problems and deliver smart solutions. We can run these initiatives as social enterprises, and there are a number of supportive different platforms that can help us bring these imaginations into reality. As youth, we are the trailblazers of a coming generation, and every step we take, we are laying down a crucial pathway which will shape our own future. As Professor Sachs mentioned, it is about our commitment towards achieving all the goals. We have to work for the SDGs. So today, I call upon all the youth to join hands and together determine to put our talks into action and report more successes next year at Vatican Youth Symposium of 2018, thus working towards developing a truly fraternal and supportive society in aligned with United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. Thank you so much.